All right, let's watch this Democracy in China video, shall we? Oops, I forgot to use my stream deck. We're advanced now. All right, let's watch this. It is called Chinese People's Democracy in Practice.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah, boy. Thank you.
我们小庙村一共是2,700口人，八百零八户，有耕地是5,370亩，水浇地吗？对，我们都是水浇地，人均差不多2亩地。今年中央的一号文件提出，持续改善农村的人居环境，塑造美丽乡村新风貌。我们给老百姓新修了13公里的水泥路，全村的。
So this is likely a party cadre. So the way the party works and the way it's worked for a long time, and obviously the Chinese Communist Party, the Communist Party of China, sorry, is the largest Communist Party in the world. I believe it has close to 1 billion members. Is it? How many members? The Communist Party of China. Whoops. I used the US name. $95 million members, so almost 100 million, not 1 billion. I don't know why I said 1 billion. That would be 1/7 of the planet. But 95 million members, so almost 100 million members. So it is centralized, right? You have the centralized party bureaucracy, but then you also have these party cadres. So you have people who belong to the party who are in charge of different areas, of different geographic regions, of different villages. And they have to ensure that certain goals for well-being and for social welfare are being met in the village, in the area that they're in charge of. So you see this woman here talking about, you know, how many people live in the village, how big the village is, and the roads that have been built, how much access the villagers have to running water. And then the party can adjust their programs and their policies of economic planning based on what the villages need, based on what the party cadres tell them.
自来水建了文化广场、卫生室、超市，我建了秧歌广场舞、舞龙舞狮这些个队伍。
That's cool. She said they built a bunch of clinics, a bunch of healthcare facilities, and then they also created a bunch of dancing teams, which is interesting and cool.
老百姓新修了2座桥，特别是我们老百姓知道说，总书记您倡导厕所，Toilet
Revolution。哎呦，他们都动情地说，就连厕所，农村可以说厕所是最小最小的、微不足道的一件事，这样的小事你都能替我们想到了，他们都非常感激党和政府。
They
upgraded the toilet facilities of the villagers, which might seem silly, but, you know, very, very important to have, like, plumbing, you know, and that's something that was built in China by the party. We always talk about how people don't compare China or communist countries in general, or countries with communist governments in general, to what they had before the revolutions, right? A lot of times in the U.S., capitalist ideologues will say, look at Cuba. You know, Cuba's more poor than the U.S., but it's like, what did Cuba have before the revolution, right? They were an agrarian society run by a U.S.-backed dictator. You know, China was a feudal agrarian country without plumbing and running water and roads, you know, and all of these things have been built over the last 70 years since the revolution.
我们的垃圾都运到哪里去？我们的垃圾有固定的掩埋点儿。对，就在当地。对，当地。就地掩埋。对对对，就地掩埋。 说实在，以前多少辈子都不敢想的事，现在都变成现实了。老百姓感激党，挺感激政府，感激这个时代。我和老百姓说过一句话，虽然说这句话有点玩笑，我说这么多好政策，总有一款适合你。说实在的，我觉得只要我们上下齐心，我们做基层工作的，付出一颗真心。
It's interesting. They're talking about the need to focus on grassroots work, and also talking about consolidating the support of the people, which have been staples of the party since it was invented.
就一定能把这个工作做好。我们小庙的富民乡村梦也一定能实现。最后，我想，我有一个请求：如果总书记能去我们赤峰市。 能去我们小庙村看一看，我们老百姓热烈欢迎你。谢谢总书记，谢谢大家，谢谢大家。
你那个村离赤峰市
90公里，对，在赤峰市西边。
赤峰市我还没去过，
欢迎总书记去。
离北京还是比较近的，将来肯定有机会去。
谢谢，我们。
That's awesome.So yeah, I get to see how their system works in action, you know. We describe a lot, or I've described a lot, the work of these party cadres and how they report back to the central bureaucracy about the area that they're in charge of, and then decisions can be made to try and get people running water, plumbing, all that kind of stuff. But it's also helpful to see it in action, right, to see how the system actually works with your eyes. So thank you for that video. Great video. Appreciate you.